Let's do a quick analysis of Joker, one of the most popular movies from 2019. This movie has gotten a lot of Oscar nominations in 2020, to the bewilderment of many people. I think there's a simple explanation for that. This movie made a ton of money. And since the Oscars are really, first and foremost, about advertising and marketing, the nominations for the Joker are inherently praising its money-making capabilities. But there's something else interesting. I think number two about the Oscars is they're about political posturing. And when you put Joker up for this many nominations, over and against the typical political posturing we get from a lot of people in Hollywood, there are some interesting ironies. So let's do a little bit of analysis of Joker and see why this is, to me, kind of funny that they nominated this movie. First, the Joker plays to any audience of any political orientation. It will confirm your bias about why people are bad or why they go bad. Of course, in Joker, Arthur Fleck becomes the ultimate bad guy, the Joker in the Batman stories. Why is this the case? Well, the movie, as I said, uses a kitchen sink theory of explanations for why Joker goes bad. One, he's in a bad environment, a bad cityscape. The urban landscape is depressing and degrading. Okay, and pair that with the fact that he's attacked by a bunch of white college preppies who probably voted for Donald Trump, and that Bruce Wayne's father, an authoritarian figure, makes fun of him and chews him out in the middle of the movie. He too is like a Donald Trump or sort of tough guy right wing character. But the movie throws other explanations out for why Arthur Fleck went bad, and I think it prioritizes these explanations. I think the chief one is that his mother has abused him. We know he laughs for no reason, or he laughs when he should be sad, or he laughs when he should shut up. The reason he's laughing is because of brain trauma suffered when he was a child. The climactic point of this movie is Arthur Fleck finding out that his mother, whom he loves in the beginning of the movie, was an abuser and violently beat him as a child. Add that to the fact that Arthur Fleck has no known father, and you have, in a way, if you want to watch it this way, a family values movie. Absentee father, terrible mother, abuses a child. This movie may be making the case that Arthur Fleck needed to be taken care of by a two-parent household, a stable, safe, loving environment. Now, you can focus on any one of these reasons why Arthur went bad, or you can take them all and go, well, the movie makers, I think, were trying to appeal to the widest possible audience, people who believe that we need two-parent households and stable fathers, or people who believe we need to harness capitalism, eliminate racism, and, in general, the woke population. Now, here's what I think is funny about Hollywood nominating this movie. Joker makes a case that in the late 1970s, something changed about American entertainment. I don't think this interpretation is historically accurate, but you get the Robert De Niro character, who's kind of a Johnny Carson figure, Tonight Show, funny, stupid jokes, a la Johnny Carson or Jay Leno. He's replaced, though, in the movie by Joker. Joker is an entertainer. The entire movie makes the case that he's a creative dancer. He's a creative entertainer type. And the Joker is sort of a liberal entertainer who's coming on the scene imposing violence, chaos, confusion. That's the sort of entertainment that's taking over the bland Tonight Show humor. Who's going to replace the Robert De Niro talk show host character? It's going to be the Joker. Why? Because, spoiler alert, at the end of the movie, all kinds of viewers respond to the Joker positively. They join his Joker army. They help him out in the end. They're responding positively to his brand of entertainment. And so this is the kind of entertainment, in Gotham City at least, that is now going to take over. So in effect, Hollywood is kind of celebrating, in part, a family values movie. That's also making an ironic point that entertainment, a la the Joker, is inherently too violent and is inherently too destructive and immoral. I don't know how you watch this movie, but I saw it as a movie that was longing for Batman to emerge and to stop the Joker. By the end of this movie, we have masked villains and chaos and rioting in Gotham City. Who wants to live in that sort of place? My guess is Hollywood won't recognize the ironies of nominating Joker, and so it's up to you to re-watch this movie and kind of see it the way I'm suggesting that you see it, in order to notice that Hollywood giving it all these nominations and accolades is kind of interesting. I'm Dr. Josh Matthews. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to this channel and please like this video. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.